literacy, yes? We can summarize by saying that all roads lead to Rome. I would say that maybe all roads may lead to Rome if doing things in the proper way. The project we are going to see now, we are going to listen, is a Comedius project. We have José Mari Fernández from Laudio High School, and as he is not going to say anything, I must say that this is a very special Comedius project because it was chosen the best Comedius project in Spain among 700 Comedius projects. So, he's going to develop in English because, as you know, it's a European project and communication takes place in English. So, Mari, I don't know if you're ready. No, you need a couple of minutes, okay. No worries, we'll wait for you. It's a very presentation, you know that takes some time to prepare it. He's very busy at the school now, and I have to thank him for coming to be here with us because you know that with the new Erasmus Plus, it is much more difficult to enter a project now, to send a project, and he's involved in a new one. So we appreciate your effort to be here because we know that you are really overwhelmed with work. Thank you very much.
Well, good afternoon. My name is José Mari Fernández, and I am a teacher at ES Laudio BHI in Laudio. And I have been invited to this presentation, thank you very much, to talk about how European projects can help us to develop our students' communication skills in a foreign language using ICT tools such as blogs and wikis. But before I start, I'd like to explain briefly about European projects. I don't know if you know about them, about the Comenius, Erasmus, and all those things, and well, I will try to talk a bit about them. European projects started quite a long time ago, I think that around 2008, before they were known as Socrates projects, and more recently as the lifelong learning programs. Inside these projects, there were different actions focusing the different educational sectors. For example, we had Erasmus for university students. We also have Leonardo for vocational training education. Grundtvig for adult education and Comenius for school projects. In our school we have worked with Comenius. Here you can see all the possibilities that were before. And now this year the European Commission has launched a new program called Erasmus Plus. And all these projects more or less has changed, but we can find the same in the new program. I will put here some of the objectives. Sorry, yeah, better now. The main objectives of the new Erasmus Plus programs are amongst.
We cannot see what they
To improve the level of key competencies and skills of students and also of teachers, to be aware of the European lifelong learning policy, to promote the mobility and cooperation between partners in different European countries, and to improve the teaching and learning of languages in Europe. Well, this has been a very short presentation about the European projects, but if you want to know more about them, you can always have more information in the websites, in the Basque government's website or in the Spanish website about the European projects. And at the end of this presentation, of course, if you want to ask me something about them, I will try to answer the questions. Well, now I'd like to start talking about our experience in our schools in the last years. We have been working in continuous projects in the last 12 years. We have worked with students in these countries, more than 10 countries, in the United Kingdom, Poland, the Netherlands, Portugal. We have taken students to these countries, and we have also some students and teachers from these schools have come to our school to visit us here also. Working with these countries and visiting the schools there has given us teachers and students the opportunity of learning about the different educational systems around Europe, practicing European languages, and strengthen the feeling of belonging to a wider community as the European Union is. Here you have got a summary of the projects my school has been involved in. We have been involved in 4 different communist projects in this year. The first one was called Citizenship, and we worked with the schools in the United Kingdom, in the Netherlands, and in Poland. The second communist project was about minority languages in Europe, and we worked with Latvia, Germany, and Turkey. After our experiences with these two projects, we decided to become the coordinators. And our third project was around environment, about water. It was called Environmentally Plugged In, and we worked with schools in the United Kingdom, Turkey, Italy, and Poland. And the last project that we finished last year, called Hands Up for a Green Energy School, it was obviously about energy, and we worked with schools in Portugal, in Hungary, Sweden, and in Reunion Island. The United Island is a French overseas territory placed in the Indian Ocean next to Madagascar. Well, whenever we have joined a communist project, we have always had in our minds an objective, what you can read here. We always wanted to give our students the opportunity to communicate in English with other partners in different European countries. This has always been our main objective. Joining this kind of projects. Now we will start talking about our last communist project. It was called, as I have told you before, Hands Up from a Green Energy School, and we had the partners in Budapest, in Hungary. Here you can see some of the pictures that we took during the mobilities. Our next school was in Sweden, in the small town of Uddevalla. Next school was in Chamuska, a small town near Lisbon. And finally, the last school was, as I have told you before, in Reunion Island. Here you can see where Reunion Island is, very far from here. It was really a big challenge for us to take students there. Well, the main topic that we worked in this in the last project was energy. And as we were 5 countries, we divided the main topic of energy in 5 small aspects, so that each school was in charge of one of them. For example, we had Portugal, and they worked, they prepared activities around paper. Sweden, they worked about heating, Reunion Island, about waste and recycling. Hungary about electricity, and our topic was food. We chose this one because two years ago, I think, we were working about it in school with the Agenda 21. And we also wanted to join the food and the energy, what happens in our canteens and everything. Well, we can't forget that our main objective is what I have told you before, was to make students in different countries communicate in English with their partners. We didn't want, with the Comenius project, to create a project with a collection of tasks made by the students individually, where the only possibility for them to communicate and to be in touch with their European colleagues was during the mobilities. We wanted our students to work in a collaborative way with the partners using English and ICT tools. We wanted our students to... we designed the task that we proposed to our students in a way that they should have to ask for information from the other students in other schools. It was compulsory for them to communicate with their partners to learn how the situation was in the different schools and countries to complete their tasks in the project. For this, we created a wiki. I don't know if you are familiar with wikis, if you know how they work, or how can you do with a wiki. But, well, I can tell you that the best well-known wiki is Wikipedia. I suppose that all of you have worked with this, with it. You know how it works. It's a big database where you can find information. Everybody can add information there. You can edit. So this is the idea of a wiki, to work collaboratively with other students in other countries. I have put here a short video, it's just 4 minutes long, to show you the possibilities of a wiki. It's an old one, perhaps you already know it, you have seen it, but I think that it's worth watching this because it can give us the idea of about what can we do with a wiki in our classes.
These four friends are going on a camping trip. They need to bring the right supplies because they're backpacking. The group needs to plan and plan well, so coordination is key. They're all computer users, so they start planning with an email. It starts with one, but then becomes a barrage. Email is not good at coordinating and organizing a group's input. This is the old way. Boo! The important information is scattered across everyone's inbox. This isn't coordination. Let's start over. There is a better way. It requires you using a website called a wiki. Using a wiki, the group can coordinate their trip better. This is the new way. Yay! Most wikis work the same. They make it easy for everyone to change what appears on a web page with the click of a button. It's as easy as erasing a word and rewriting it. The buttons are really important. There are two that are essential. They are edit and save, and they are always used together. Let's see them in action. Here are our camping friends, and this is a wiki website. Like all wikis, it has an edit button. Clicking this button transforms the web page into a document. All you have to do is click it, and the web page becomes a document, ready for editing. Editing the page means you can add or remove words or change how they look, just like writing a letter. Once you're finished editing, you click save and the document becomes a web page once again and is ready for the next person to edit it. Easy. Edit, write, and save. Using this process, a group can coordinate more easily. Let's apply this to our camping friends who need to bring the right supplies. Mary signs up for a wiki site and then sees the new site for the first time. She clicks the edit button to get started. She creates two lists for camping, what we have and what we need. Under we have, she lists the things she will bring, a cooler, stove, and flashlight. Under we need, she lists items that others need to bring, compass, lighter, water, and food. She finishes the process by clicking save, and the website now has lists for the camping trip. Now it's John's turn. John visits the wiki website, clicks edit, and the page becomes a document ready for him to make changes. John volunteers to bring food and water, so he moves those to the have column. He also realizes the group will need a knife and rope. Once he's finished, he clicks save and the wiki is ready for the next person. Henry visits the wiki, clicks edit, and he can edit the page. He remembers they need a tent. Henry saves the page and the wiki is ready for Frank. Frank edits the page and agrees to bring the remaining items, completing the process. Frank saves the page and realizes something awesome. The group has created the perfect camping list without email. Yay! But wait, one thing is missing. They need a location for the campsite. The wiki can help with this too, but another page is needed. John visits the wiki and clicks edit to edit the page. He types in the word locations and highlights it.
He then clicks the link button.
This changes the word locations into a link to a new page. John clicks save and next, Frank visits the wiki and sees the list and the link to the new page. He clicks on the locations link and arrives at the new page. This new page enables the group to use the same edit, write, save process to coordinate locations. This process can be repeated over and over.
These three buttons, edit, save, and link, make it possible to organize a great camping trip or create the world's biggest encyclopedia.
You can sign up for your own wiki at these websites, PVWiki, WebPaint, or WikiSpaces. I'm Leland Beaver, and this has been Wikis in Plain English on the Common Craft Show.
Well, this is a simple way of explaining what a wiki is and how to work with wikis. And in our project, as I have told you before, we were five countries working together, and we used this way, using the wiki, to fulfill our aim, that was putting students communicating together with the partners in other countries. So in this way, for example, the project was about energy, and here you can see, for example, Portugal, the world charge of paper, and Portuguese students using the wiki had to learn about the situation related to the use of paper in all the countries. How much paper was it used in the country, in the schools, if all the schools use recycled paper, how many photocopies are made in a week, in a month, in a year, if we use both sides when we make photocopies. That's all what the students did, Portuguese students. But of course, to do this, they had to communicate with the other students in the other countries using the wiki. They had to prepare questions for the other students. At the same time, for example, the Swedish students who were working around heating, they had to investigate about the use of the heating system in each of the schools, if the buildings were properly isolated, for example, the average temperature in each school, type of heating system, and which one was the more environmentally effective way. And again, to do all this, they had to communicate with their partners in all the other schools. Here we have got the Hungarian team, they work around electricity. Then we had students from Reunion Island working around the waste, and if everything was recycled in the schools, so what kind of things were recycled. And then we work around food. We wanted to know, for example, about the food served in the different canteens. If the use of seasonal and local products, for example, if the menus were balanced, and especially how much food was wasted every day, because this is a really, really big problem in our school. We throw every day a lot of food, and we wanted to know how the situation was like in the other schools. And again, students did. Every student, they were working in their own task, but they had to communicate with the students in the other countries. We will see this later in the wiki. But this is how we developed the project. It was a 2 year project, so the first year we worked in the first and in the second step. The first step was general research, so all the students in all the schools work here, they had to know about the situation in their school, about the five topics, the waste, paper, food, electricity, and heating, and they also had to be aware of the problems that there were in each of these topics. For example, in our school, well, it was food, we work around food, but for example, electricity sometimes, it also happens in our school, when we go to the break or when the students go to the laboratory, sometimes the lights are always on, although there's nobody in the classroom. So all the students were searching for this kind of problems in each of the schools. The second step was, as I have explained to you before, and using the wiki, they had to focus in their own topic and asking questions to their partners, know about it, and to have conclusions and to know about the problems. In the second year, we try to find solutions to those problems. And for that, we prepare an aware campaign. Once students knew about the different problems, we told them, okay, now select each problem, and you have to create a short video showing that problem and how you can solve it, or at least make people aware, students, teachers, and parents also, of the problems that you have found in the different schools. I will show some of them later. Well, this is the wiki. I have to tell you that the wiki, well, if you are not a member of the group, and you obviously aren't, if you enter it, it's like a, you will find here a kind of chaos, because you won't understand really anything. We teachers, we didn't also have, wanted to have a lead role here. It was the space for students to express themselves. We only, for example, corrected the mistakes where they were impossible, for example, to understand what they wanted to say. Apart from that, here you can find some mistakes, but we didn't want to correct everything, because our aim was to put students communicating, and of course, if you are correcting them all the time, finally they don't do anything. Well, for example, here each of the countries had a page. We have got France, the Basque Country, Hungary, Portugal, and Sweden. Let's have a look to the French page. Okay, this is the place where students from the different countries communicate. So to fulfill their tasks, they have to communicate with the other students. Here we can see, for example, how the Swedish students prepare the questions, and then, as it is a wiki, and we have seen before, we can add information, we can edit, so the other students could enter here and answer the questions. So here we can see the different questions that all the students prepared for the other teams. This was the Swedish students' questions. Here we have got a survey prepared by our students about the food in the different schools. For example, we wanted to know, well, about how many times a week, what amount it is served, salad, pasta, vegetables in the different schools. So here there are our questions and the answers of the schools from the Reunion Island. And it was the same in the other pages for the other schools. So this is the way that we found here to communicate students from the different countries. Here, for example, we have got students from Hungary. Again, we have got their questions or their comments, and then the answer from the other students. Then, with all this information, students had to prepare presentations that were used during the international mobilities. So each country had to prepare a presentation, for example, the students from Reunion, about the situation of the waste and recycling in all the countries. In our case, for example, we prepared a presentation about food in all the canteens, what was happening there, and it was presented, for example, when we traveled to Portugal. Well, this is the idea of a wiki. Here there were, of course, more tasks. Here they were working around, I think, music in the different countries, and they were all the time communicating and asking questions of their partners in the other countries. Well, apart from this, I would like to show you some of the videos that students prepare about that awareness campaign about the use of energy. Some of them are really nice. Mm-hmm. Let's have a look at this one. This was made by the students in Sweden, and it was a long paper. It's a bit longer, but it's very funny. Coming to to work on the project, it was something really good for me. But if I have
you go every year?
But it depends. It depends. For example, in the last project we were 5 countries, and the project was for 2 years. So the first year, we visited only 2 countries. This is, we went to Greenland Island and to Sweden. And last year, 3 countries. But one of them was our own country, so we only moved to another 2. But it depends. 2 or 3 trips a year.
Somebody commented before, I think that this is another clear example of teachers from different areas working together. Somebody mentioned before that it was, meaning I think it was from Mugia, that it was a very suitable project, not only for languages, but also for the history teacher. In this case, you can see how it can be used in citizenship, tutorials, science, and obviously English. Thank you very much, Jose Mari.